Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Lwando Mdleleni. I will be giving an update report on the activities that have been performed by Zenzelec in the past 6 months, together with my colleague, Masbela Lisia. And I might call upon another colleague, Carlos Moreno, if needed, hopefully not. Michiku, if I exceed my allocated time, please punish me. But I will determine the nature of punishment. Perhaps just to start by giving a brief background on Zenzeleni to those who are not familiar with Zenzeleni. And again, if you don't see me in the photos, I'm the one who's taking them. Zenzeleni Networks is a community network from South Africa in the poorest province of the Eastern Cape, actually the district, and is found in deep rural areas of Mangosi, where people live under US dollars, under $2 per day, and people used to spend 22% of their income on communication. And then to counter this phenomenon, Zenzeleni was established. And initially, Zenzeleni provided voice services through Wi-Fi mesh network, which was connected to 12 routers that were deployed in the community. As such, people were able to make voice over IP calls for free within the community, and the breakout calls were charged at a 50% less price than what the mobile network providers charge. So, in a summary, in a nutshell, that's what Zenzeleni initially did. However, we have since upgraded the services or our line of business. I hate using the term business, but we will elaborate on that as we proceed. Perhaps before I continue, I think it fits to share a word of gratitude and appreciation to ISOC Beyond the Net for the assistance, the support that they've given us. Without such support, we wouldn't have been able to achieve what we've achieved so far. And the amount of, the magnitude of what you're doing for such community networks is beyond your understanding. So thank you so much. I'm going to quickly give to my colleague Jay to elaborate on the technical activities that we've carried out in the last 6 months. In a summary, this is the community net. The picture below, the shade there, with the community cooperative. Those are the charging stations and the telephone station. There's a community there installing a solar system. Community is also there installing solar system. The shade there testing the VoIP calls. That's what we were doing initially. So I'm going to give it to Jay. Jay?
Thank you very much, Lwando. My name is Jay Masbulelisia from South Africa. And briefly, I'm going to give a very short update about what has been done in the last 6 months in the technical side of the Zenzeleni. And apparently, from the beginning of the project, we were using a mesh wireless devices, which were just providing wireless network, and we were only having one single radio. Then for that, because the demand of the community were looking something much more bigger to the service that Zenzeleni provide. So what Zenzeleni is trying to do is doing provides a service that are required by the community, because it's the land that belongs to the community. For that to happen, so we had to upgrade these devices to get a new version of mesh potato that allows two radios, so to allow our system to function effectively. So luckily, fortunately enough, there were newly introduced wireless network devices that are mesh potatoes that allows us to do this, to allow this to provide services. So we changed that based on that. And the third point is one of the plans in the land was to rent space on telecom towers. And for that, as we all agreed earlier on, that it's really ridiculous prices that we can get from them. So we bring up that there's no sustainable way for us to afford them. So for that, we had to go to consult different people to see what are the cheapest way to do it. Eventually, we ended up finding a solution and forging partnership with Waterloo University in Mthatha that can allow us to have the internet. But for that, we are having a very unfortunate part that we didn't have a line of sight from our community to Mthatha. So it's the distance between Mthatha and our community is like 7 to 8 kilometers. So we didn't have any line of sight. For that, we had to find a reliable solution like tower. So we eventually find a tower that allows us to have this line of sight from our community to Mthatha. And from our community to one of the communities that has our tower. So it's about 20 kilometers away from our community, from the community from the university where our backbone is. So it's like 40 to 50 kilometers. So for that, we managed to unlock that problem. And it's more like a reliable problem because from this tower, we can see more than 30 communities that can access the tower, access our internet. So this is one of the solutions that we have achieved late in the last 6 months. So in a way, we have been like kind of trying to figure out what the best solution is. It might take a bit of time, but why it's taking time? Because we are all learning on this, and also we find a really good solution that will be more sustainable and make our project especially to grow much more bigger. So I will again give back to Rwando. Thank you.
Thank you, Jay. I'm going to proceed with the rest of the presentation. One of the activities or the demands from the community, the organizations, the businesses, and in particular the schools, was for Zenzeleni to provide them with internet, with internet services. For us, we believe, I think Carlos in his presentation also highlighted that, I think many ICT projects fail in our communities because we only provide facilities hoping that they are going to speak to the needs of the community. As such, we don't understand if people have the know-how or the skill of utilizing such facilities. And then people may not even understand the benefits of such facilities. So it was our duty when we went to schools to first make sure that before providing internet, the criteria was set up. Before providing internet, to understand that the teachers know how to utilize computers. So we performed a digital skills needs assessment baseline survey so that we can develop a training program that is going to speak to the training or digital needs of these teachers. When we went to set up the computers, we found out that in one school, the high school, out of 34 computers, only 4 is functional. In the other school, even though all the computers were working, but there was electrical problems. Our other major activity that we ought to do was to provide educational content, which we're going to install in these computers. And one of the main ambitions is to provide educational content in an indigenous language, obviously, because all, as it was stated in the report, 90% of the content that is available online is in English. And it's a serious challenge in our communities for learners to understand the concepts of certain subjects when they are presented in English. We have encountered in the past 6 months numerous challenges. Firstly, some of our activities were delayed. We couldn't achieve them in time because of unforeseen circumstances. As Jay has said, we were hoping to connect to Telkom back home, but it didn't happen, and therefore we had to find an alternative. However, that became a blessing in disguise for us. I'll elaborate on that later. The site selection, those that we've asked in the trainings, I think Amando highlighted this. When we had to set up the tower, oh, by the way, that's Jay there. I took the picture. When we had to set up the tower, as Jay said, it's 20 kilometers away from our community. And when we got there, the tribal authority of that particular community wanted to charge us 5,000 rands per month. And just next to, not far from our town, there's a Telkom tower that's been there, and no one is going to charge them for that. So we had to find an alternative solution to that, like directly go to the family that owns the land, and we managed to put our tower for free. Another delay was that of digital skills training. The schools heavily depend on the government to subsidize them, to have the computers prepared, and also for them to offer the internet. As you know, I think Billy, Tato, you know our government. When it came to school, there were budgetary constraints, and there was red tape, lots of bureaucracy, and still, we're still waiting for the computers to be prepared. But we are in the process of intervening, and we're hoping that this matter will be solved very soon. Also, as a matter of highlighting, I think one of the main challenges that as community networks we need to overcome, and the path that we need to take, we need to have a way of making sure that the people within the community understand the benefits of the services that we provide, and how the services are going to uplift the community and then uplift them in their personal capacity. As such, it is imperative for us to research the barriers to uptake and provide collectively with the solution, with the communities, provide solutions. Just briefly going through our upcoming, just short of upcoming activities, I took the picture. We're going to get the internet fully operational. Once that is done, the two schools are going to be connected. We continue with providing the digital skills, and then we store the digital content in the computers. Activities for noting. I didn't take that one. We entered a Mozilla Equality Innovation Challenge, and we're proud to say that out of hundreds of other projects, we made it into the top five, and we went to, yes. Out of the top five in the finals in New York, we came number four. Even though we did not win, the challenge, but we took invaluable lessons. And the path that we took is a path that we'll take again and use the lessons for a better understanding. One of the advantages that this competition has enabled us, it has created an exposure for Zenzeleni. As such, in about a 10 days time, we are getting a visit from provincial government, and we are hoping they're interested to see what we're doing. And they seek to understand how we can form a collaboration. And if you look at this, it will speak to the challenge of the schools that I spoke about. So it's a win-win for us. But I hope it's not rhetoric, because it's the government here.